Polymorphism is a feature of inheritance that allows classes to have more than one type. Within an inheritance hierarchy, any child class can be said to be a parent class. This means that any time a base class is needed, a derived class can be used in its place. Let's say we have a game that uses an inheritance hierarchy where orc and goblin are derived from enemy, which in turn is derived from humanoid. One thing you might want to do is create a collection of all the enemy objects in the scene. Rather than having two collections, one for all the orcs and one for all the goblins, you can have one collection of enemy objects that both orc objects and goblin objects could be elements of. Similarly, if you also had a player class that inherited from humanoid, then you could create a collection of all of the humanoid objects in a scene, and it could contain all orcs, goblins, and players. Polymorphism also works for things like function parameters. Consider the onTrigger functions. Generally, they have a collider parameter, which is usually called something like other. Game objects do not have a collider component on them. However, they could have a box collider, sphere collider, mesh collider, or something similar. When the onTrigger functions are called, we don't know which type of collider is being used. In fact, each object's specific collider is passed into the function. Since all of these different colliders inherit from the collider parent class, any of them will work. It is important to know that the opposite is not possible. Using our previous example, an orc is an enemy, but an enemy is not an orc. You cannot have something expecting a child class and give it a parent class. One slightly clever use of polymorphism involves constructors and object references. You can declare an object of a base class type, and then call the constructor of one of its derived classes. This is because the variable reference is expecting something of the base class's type, and the constructor of the child class creates something of a derived type. If this seems confusing, just remember that a child class is a parent class. Therefore, this conversion works and is a process known as upcasting. While an object is upcasted, it can only be treated as an object of its parent class. In this example, while child class is upcasted, it can only be treated as a parent class. This means that only the variables and methods available in the parent class can be used, and they will be treated as if they were in an object of the parent class. The exception to this is virtual functions, which will call the most overridden version. For more information about virtual functions and overriding them, see the lesson on overriding linked below. In order to treat this child class like a child class, we need to downcast the child class variable back into the child class type. We do this by enclosing the name of the type in brackets and putting it in front of the variable. We can either enclose this in another set of brackets and use the dot operator to access members, or we can create a reference to this new version.